Good morning students, myself Veet Palkar. Today I will teach you chapter 2, the end of bipolarity for class 12th, subject political science. I have already made videos regarding this chapter. In these videos we have already learnt about Russian Revolution, condition of USSR after Second World War and even economic condition of USSR. Today we will touch a new concept, that is state ownership was the dominant form of ownership. Let's start it. Now students, we will do discussion why Russian USSR people were not satisfied with the state. State ownership was dominant from the form of ownership. Means state was everything. Everything what was in the country, what was in the country was under state. State means government. Government means communist party. And land and productive assets owned by the government. I already told you in previously, land and productive assets were owned by government. Nobody could take personal benefit from any kind of profit and land and productive sources. However, Soviet system became very bureaucratic and authoritarian, making life difficult for citizens. One thing was this, that land and productive assets were owned by government. Because for example, in India, you can buy anything, you can enjoy privileges if you do hard work. But in USSR, this could not happen. And next point is Soviet system became bureaucratic. As I have already done discussion, that there was no opposition party. That's why Soviet system became bureaucratic and authoritarian. And this was the thing that making puzzle to the people to follow the policies of USSR. And next point is unaccountable. Here unaccountable, nobody was responsible to give answer regarding any kind of policy in USSR. USSR was made up by Russia plus 14 other countries. Russia was the dominant and everything. That's why what was decided by Russia, other 14 countries were following them. That's why there was a little bit, you can say, little bit difficulty among the people to follow the policies of USSR. And the Soviet Union was lagging behind the West in the technology and infrastructure. This point I want to clear to you. Whenever anybody from Russia visited to France and US, on that time they felt that their technology was not much advanced as US and France was. That's why people were feeling dissatisfaction from the system of Russia, from the system of USSR. Now student, the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan in 1970 weakened the system even further. We know about Red Army. Red Army is the largest army of the world, and it was thought that it is the most powerful army. If this will attack on you, nobody can save you. In 1979, Red Army got invasion in Afghanistan. USSR invaded Afghanistan, but in 1989. Red Army came back to their own country. Why this happened? Because Afghanistan was supported by US economically and military, both kind of support was given by USA to Afghanistan, and Pakistan also helped. Due to insurgent groups attacked on Red Army. So that's why people were feeling frustrated. Then apart from that, if you sent any army in another country, there is a lot of expenses. There are a lot of expenses. Due to that, there was economic loss. That's why people were being frustrated from this tweet. Students, next is productivity and technology. Productivity was lesser as compared to the another time. So when productivity was lesser, and due to that there was shortage of consumer goods, you can say food. There was shortage of food, that's why food was imported. And due to that, Soviet economy was faltering. Late 1970s.